Hey there, welcome back to True North Reviews. My name is Ryan, and today we're doing an episode of Hot and Cold. This is a video series I like to do where I talk about the best and worst music I heard over the past week. Specifically for this upload, we'll be talking about any songs put out between July 7th and 13th, 2019. As per usual, the songs will be linked down in the description if you want to check any of these songs out. And for future episodes, if you want to give me suggestions, feel free to let me know. Without further ado, let's jump into the hot tracks of the week. First up, I want to be talking about the latest remix from Lil Nas X, Old Town Road. We've all heard it at this point, hopefully. But man, we have another remix to talk about here. This one is featuring Mason Ramsey, the Yodeling Kid, and Young Thug. And honestly, I think Young Thug gets outperformed by Mason Ramsey. It's just the whole yippee-ki-yay, if you ain't got no giddy up, then getty out my way. Like, that's just hysterical. That's pure comedy gold. And what makes that even funnier is just how Mason puts this yodel inflection on his voice before we head into that last chorus. And this song remains as anthemic as ever, if not even more anthemic than it was before. And yeah, we're at that point where Old Town Road, we only need a few more weeks for it to remain as number one on the Billboard Hot 100 for it to become the longest running single at the number one spot of all time. And really trying to wrap my head around that, it honestly feels like a privilege to be a part of this kind of music history if it does come true. If this becomes the longest running number one single of all time, sure, it is a meme, but it's a good song either way, and I'll still appreciate it for all of its glory. Moving on from there, another hot track this week I have to recommend is I'm Not Alright by Loud Luxury and Bryce Vine. This is definitely the best single that Loud Luxury has released since his 2018 single, Body. This song is just bouncy, it's got a fun melody, we got some great production that doesn't dominate over the vocal performance, and it's a perfect song for the summer. Next up from there, we have David Guetta and Martin Solveig. They have come together to put out a single entitled Thing For You. This is another dance track, and I'm surprised as much as the next person to see that I have two dance songs on the hot list this week. I don't know how often that really happens whenever we get at least even one EDM kind of single, but I'm loving it, and I'm just gonna appreciate it. But yeah, this David Guetta single here, I love Sasha Sloan's vocals on here. They're pretty commendable, and her performances before this, she's been on Kygo singles before. I haven't really been blown away with those. But yeah, what really drives home this song, I am really getting into the interesting beat drop. I think it's one of the more unique ones of David Guetta's discography over the past few years. So it feels like he's kind of clinging on to relevancy at this point. I know he was a bigger name back in the early 2010s, but this new single from him is worth checking out in my opinion. I checked out this next artist's newest song because of the collaboration he did with Mavis Staples earlier this year. I'm talking about Ben Harper and his song Uneven Days. This is a piano ballad. It slows things down from those previous two tracks I talked about. This one is notably a straightforward song for its lyrics and composition, and hell, even the vocals won't really blow you away, but I just love how earnest this song is. Another hefty and substantial wall of sound is thrown in our faces with the latest Sum 41 single over this past week. It is called 45, A Matter of Time, and sure, the triplet guitar rhythms are pretty overused in metalcore, but the bread and butter to this song is certainly the vocal melody, which doesn't have much going for it. It circles around two or three notes and it remains pretty static, but there's a lot of weight and momentum on this track, and it just barrels ahead with the storm that it is. Moving on from there, I want to give a shout out to Bru Castellano for his latest single, Verses. The lyricism on this is just so strong. There are lots of puns on his own name, loads of sports references. If you're into any sports as much as I am, you'll get a kick out of it. And there's even some great wordplay on here, like with TNT and brew, no, we becoming brutal. The first verse of the song even has some Childish Gambino-like sexual references, which I have to admire. And the vocal deliveries on here are very diverse. They keep me on the edge of my seat while I listen to it. And the instrumental is pretty professional grade quality, I would say. It goes toe-to-toe with a lot of the rap tracks that have piqued my interest this year so far, so good on Brew Castellano. Next up, I want to talk about Bon Iver. He has released two singles this past week. The first one I will be talking about is called Faith. This is a hot track this week. It will be on his forthcoming album, II, that is the name of it, and it's set to release on August 30th. That is the end of summer. And on this track, Faith in particular, we get some trademark falsettos, which are just so Bon Iver at this point. Like, you just know it is Bon Iver when you listen to it. In addition to this, I find the acoustic guitar playing super sweet and angelic. The subtle hip-hop influence to the sub-bass is a nice element to weave into the track. It gives this eclectic range of creativity. The synthesizers that wash over the middle section of the song are pretty grandiose and theatrical, typical things that you would see in any concoction of art pop, and it really is an utter beauty to listen to. It's like I can see the colors and I can see the music in front of my eyes. Wrapping up the hot tracks this week, we have one of two new singles from Division. He is on the OVO label with Drake. The song I want to shout out here is entitled In Between, and this song has a lot of vulnerable songwriting to it, and it's got some neat 80s style production in the chorus. I find myself coming back to this track quite a bit in the past week. Now, switching gears up, we're going to talk about the middle of the road tracks this week. These are songs I thought were okay, not the best. They aren't blowing me out of the water, but they aren't the worst either. They just might be something you want to listen to. And we're going to continue to talk about Division. His other single that he put out this past week is entitled Miss Me. And this one has a lot of ambient style production to it. It's very laid back for R&B music, and I just find this one not as memorable as the other song I mentioned. Moving on from there, we have the other Bon Iver single that dropped last week. Gelmore is the name of this one. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. This one is very glitchy. We get some jazzy tones thrown on this track. It's very compelling to an extent. I just feel like the vocals feel like they've been done before in a more interesting way from Justin Vernon. Of Monsters and Men have released their latest single in support of their upcoming album. I already did a full-length review of this. The song's called Wild Roses. If you want to check it out, feel free to do so, but just to summarize, I'm kind of let down with this one. It feels like this track has a bit more in-your-face style electronic instrumentation to it. In other words, I think I just prefer Of Monsters and Men when they are benefiting from this raw production style and just playing their instruments as they would in a live setting. And I still like the chorus on this track. It is very energetic. And it's just unfortunate that it is placed up against these really boring verses and one of the most dry and cut vocal performances from Nana. Next up, we have a song from Big Crit off his new album, Prove It. This one's featuring J. Cole. This one feels underwhelming, and it's very understated with its hook. The auto-tune is a little too distracting. However, I find the vocal performance, especially from J. Cole, to be the highlight here. There isn't much enthusiasm from Big Crit on here, but yeah, definitely J. Cole is the saving grace to this song. He absolutely kills it with a very empathetic verse about his come up in the rap game and how he has struggled with the fear of what people will think of him if he puts out all of his uncountable songs that he has written over the years. It just comes down to this point where J. Cole outshines Big Crit on his own track, and it kind of feels like a shame that this feature couldn't have come on a more memorable song. Now, wrapping up this week with some cold tracks, these are by far the worst songs I heard. I wouldn't recommend them unless you want to bang your head against the wall or you want to have a good laugh. In any way, I am just not a fan of them. And first up, we have the new Beyoncé single, Spirit. This is in support of the new Lion King soundtrack. And this is as melodramatic of a song as you would expect for this kind of movie. There's an unnecessary key change on here. There's a bland melody, and I don't like the structure to this. I do respect the vocal ability of Beyoncé. She has a wide vocal range to pull off everything that she sings on here. I just don't like this song. Moving on from there, we have a big disappointment of a song I really like, the regular version at least. This is Billie Eilish's Bad Guy. She teamed up with Justin Bieber this past week to put out another version of this song. I like the close miking of Billie's vocals on here. It complements the track very well. But Justin, his sultry, boyish voice does not offer anything special for this remix, and it's so dull and uninteresting, I will never come back to it. I still love this song, I just don't like this new one. That's all I'll say. Next up, we have Tread by Looney. This is an R&B artist, kind of the indie vein. She came out with a very stock and diluted R&B song here this past week. There's not much reward in listening to this song. It's over before you know it. It's a quick listen. I guess, like, that's the positive going for it, but it's in that way that you listen to it and you're just like, oh, is that it? Very unsatisfying listen. I just feel like it's constantly moving towards a bigger climax without actually having any relief to that climax. Quickly moving on from there, we have a new Mike Posner single featuring Ty Dolla $ign. This one is called Look What I've Become. Mike legitimately, he just sounds like Mark Foster from Foster the People on here with one of the most monotonous instrumentals of the year. Ty Dolla $ign tries to make the best of this song during his feature, but the song is so mediocre and mundane. It's something that I am not rushing to come back to anytime soon. French Montana has a new single called Wiggle It featuring City Girls. This one has an incessant and gross vocal performance to it. The overused sample of Nightcrawler's Push the Feeling On. Even if you don't know what song I'm talking about, you'll know it if you play it. It's the same song that is used in Pitbull's Hotel Room Service. And yeah, this new French Montana song, not cutting it. And last but not least, this week we have a new Tory Lanez single called Mealy, and this one is so nondescript and atrocious. It's just trap rap on cruise control with not much going for it. It's just got an annoying recorder sampled into its instrumental, and yeah, couldn't recommend it. And there you have it, there's Hot and Cold for this week. Thanks for watching, thanks for checking out these songs, and thanks for listening to my opinions on them. As always, I'd love to hear from you. Sound off down below in the comments, let me know what you think of these songs. Leave a like while you're at it, subscribe if you're new in town. Thanks for watching, I'll catch you next time, and have a rocking day.